What's going on, guys? JB here, bringing you a video about Anthem. So yes, we have the open demo this weekend. Anthem will be out soon. VIP demo last weekend. So I wanted to make a little bit of video. Sorry I haven't been on much. Honestly, I've just been busy. For those of you who don't know, I actually run a jiu-jitsu academy, and we moved our academy, expanded to a bigger place. And it's been very, very busy time doing that. Plus, honestly, my main game is Destiny, and Destiny is boring as hell right now. No offense, but it really is. I find it hard to keep my interest. The PvP is unbalanced and frustrating. The PvE content is leaves a lot to be desired. I don't know. It's just not as fun right now. So, but I'm super pumped about Anthem. I'm really hoping BioWare can, you know, pull this off really well. But I want to talk about a few things, okay? No BS stuff. There's a lot of stuff floating around right now, you know, and EA is not the most loved company out there. I'll try to stay as objective as possible, but to be completely honest with you, I've been having fun just laughing at some of the videos lately. You know, content creators capitalizing on the outrage culture that we have right now and just throwing out all these videos. So I'm going to call a couple of bullshits on a few things and just talk about a few things. So first off is this. This is the screenshot that kind of went viral of the EA store, like just a mock-up of the Anthem store, and people were just going nuts.
Global bullshit. I call bullshit. Bullshit!
You know, there's skins there. Like, oh, you know, these skins, I'm not paying $20 for a skin, because they look at these things. And, yeah. So, first of all, definitely bullshit. We don't know. It was a mock-up. And yes, it's okay. We have been burned in the past by EA, especially with Battlefront 2. So I understand people like just jumping the gun here. But do we really need like 10 goddamn videos about this thing? Seriously, like, is it really that big a deal yet? No. And of course, you know, EA has a way of sneaking it and maybe sneaking it in the game later, a la Activision, what they did with Black Ops. But seriously, it really doesn't warrant as much like hate as it is getting. I can understand where it's coming from, but I really don't think it's needed, for real. Especially considering that you can earn these items within game coin, and yes, we don't know about how long the grind is going to be, okay? But that stuff in that store is paying for future content, because expansions are going to be free, like, content in the future is going to be free. So, I'm okay with that. I'm actually okay with it, you know? It's okay to me. I really don't care. I'm not a cosmetic person, I guess. I don't really care too much about cosmetics. So it doesn't affect me as much as it might someone else that might spend money on that stuff. All I know is that I pay my money for the game, or I'll pay for my Origin access, right? And then I get future content for free. So honestly, I'm cool with that. So there it is right there. I mean, seriously. And besides, we don't really know the final numbers. And we don't know how much these things are going to cost. And I do have to say one thing. I have to pat BioWare on the back here. They have been very open, honest, and transparent about a lot of things. They've been very active on Twitter. I kind of think that BioWare are fans of Warframe because they are like modeling digital extremes to an extent when it comes to how they deal with the community. You know, and that's a good thing because I love Warframe. I think digital extremes is amazing. So yeah, I think that's a good thing. Now, the second thing I want to talk about here is the controversy over Origin Access Premier subscribers getting the game essentially early, like what, a week early? Something like that. So everyone else gets the game around the 22nd of February, and Origin Access Premier subscribers get the game on the 15th. Look, I'm going to say this. You're not going to see that many PC players on the hate train for this, right? Especially considering that typically when a console-focused game, as Anthem is, if you play the game, you understand that. It's built for, like, controller. You know, we're getting it a few days early. That happens to PC gamers all the time. We get shafted on games all the time. Most of the time, us PC gamers get crappy ports of these games, right? And we complain about it. So I don't fault you for complaining that console users or non-Origin Access Premier subscribers can't play the game early. And I understand that it's kind of a cash grab, okay? But if I'm paying $14 a month or whatever it costs for Origin Access Premier, I would honestly like some perks other than a handful of games. So I'm actually okay with this too. If you don't like it, then freaking wait a few days. Seriously, you're going to stop all your whining and moaning about this once the game comes out anyway, and you'll find something else to complain about. So So yeah, I understand why people are frustrated about it, but to be honest with you, is it really that big a deal? It's not. It's really not, okay? It just is what it is, all right? So I really don't see that big a deal of it. Even if I wasn't getting the game early, which I am because I'm an Origin Access Premier subscriber, but that doesn't matter. I'm still not going to jump on the hate train about it because I understand why they're doing it. They've done it before with previous games, and it is what it is, so yeah. And then another thing I've been seeing is a lot of the comparisons between the graphics of the initial trailers that EA presented with the demo product. And now this is something I actually have to voice out too. Like, I can't believe the differences. Like, the world looked much more richly detailed in previous, like, 2017, 2018 footage. You know, the looked like there were more creatures in the world. The AI for the creatures looked pretty cool. Even Fort Tarsus seemed more populated and much more intricate in how things were. The color grading was better in the trailer versions we got early on. Weather effects more intense, lighting more intense. So I think the game looks great. Don't get me wrong. I really do. I love the visuals in the game. But I do miss that look that the original footage had. So I'm a little frustrated with that. I wish that they would, like, maybe they realized how much work that put into, because the world is pretty big. I mean, when you look at the unlocked areas and the verticality, so maybe that was just too much work for them. I don't know. But yeah, that is something to, you know, you can kind of complain about too, is that it does not look like what we were presented originally. Yes. Gameplay wise though, I have to say, I do like the game. I kind of feel like it's a cross between Warframe meets Iron Man-ish, you know, thing. But one thing I think that can be improved upon here is the gunplay. You know, the powers are cool and all, but that stuff's going to wear pretty thin pretty fast. You know, especially being a Warframe player, I'll tell you that spamming powers can get a little boring after a while. So the gunplay, if the gunplay is crisp and sharp, it makes the gameplay, the playability longer for you, especially in the higher level message, right, where you have to use a lot more of your arsenal. The marksman rifles feel good. They feel powerful. The heavy pistols feel okay. But to be completely honest with you, the snipers are not fun to use. I don't really think they don't feel powerful. The shotgun, same way, very underwhelming. Most of the guns in general feel underwhelming. Like I said, I typically play with marksman rifles because they have that oomph factor, right, that shotguns and snipers should have. So if they need to work on anything, I think that the feeling of the weapons and the sounds need to be a little more intense than they are right now. Other than that, abilities feel good, powers feel good, movement, flight needs to be fixed on mouse and keyboard still. So does swimming. Swimming was very frustrating. A few times I played the stronghold and I jumped down into the water and I was like, where the heck, turning yourself around trying to get where you need to go can be a little bit frustrating. But other than that, I've been having a lot of fun with it. I really look forward to release. I've been trying to fix my stream setup so I can stream some content there and make some more videos for this. I may hop on Destiny again in the future. I'm not sure. I play a little bit here and there. It just doesn't keep my interest. The peer-to-peer netcode with the way the game is balanced right now is just not very fun for me. I like to, when I'm playing a PvP game or, you know, a multiplayer game like that, I want my kills to be because of skill. I want my deaths to be because someone was better than me. And Destiny's not really like that. Essentially, for the most part, it is. I mean, but there's just too many circumstances where it's just RNG or, you know, it just gets frustrating. If I want to play a skill-based shooter, a game, you know, I'd play something else. It's just Destiny's a little too frustrating. But other than that, yeah, let me know what you guys think about Anthem. If you go out and watch a lot of the content creators' stuff today, or even earlier in the week, they have a lot of endgame activity from a newer version of Anthem that you can watch. That gives you a little more than the demo we got, because the demo is quite a few weeks old. So yeah, let me know what you think. Let me know what your favorite javelin is. I'm really curious to hear what you guys think. I honestly liked the Ranger the most in the demo build. I think I may change my mind when we get to endgame builds and have more gear. But the Ranger just felt fun to me. I like the crowd control abilities. I like the feel of the abilities. I like being able to use the guns in conjunction with what I'm using. So, yeah, I really enjoyed that. But I'm curious to see what you guys think. I think the Storm is probably the most popular right now. So, yeah, I look forward to making future content, guys. And, yeah, take care. Talk to you soon.